So, every country in certain regions have their own livestock protection breed, or several breeds to protect the livestock. An example of a livestock protector is the Spanish Mastiff, also known as the Mastín Español. I did a video on that, but today I want to talk to you about a different type of livestock guardian, which is the Turkish Kangal. So the livestock guardian of Turkey, which is a different approach. So for example, the Mastín Español is a very strong, big, big-bodied livestock guardian. It's outweighing wolves with males at least 2 times on average, whereas a Kangal is more of a 1.5 times the size of a wolf. That brings a dog that's also very big, with 60 kilograms for a male, for example, but it's a lot more athletic as well. So you get a faster dog that's also able to cover ground a lot better than, for example, Spanish Mastiff can. And the thing is, it still has a very powerful bite, so it can take care of wolves. You can kill them. And the added benefit is that you can have some man-made things to introduce for example to enter your dog into that role while it is guarded by a collar. And this is a thicker collar, but they even get a broader collar of good material which adds spikes to them. So when a wolf tries to rupture the arteries in the neck region, it will be hard. Also when the dog wants to be stopped by wolves, by for example suffocating him or keeping him in a throat hold, this will be very hard to even impossible, because the dog is protected by a strong collar and there are also spikes in them. So if a wolf tries to bite the guardian breed, he will inflict a lot of damage on himself instead of on the dog, what was his purpose. So that helps a lot and also allows for less dogs to be used, or smaller dogs to be used than, for example, the Mastín Español, which is quite big. The added benefit is that you can keep, for example, 3 Kangal dogs for the food needed by 2 Mastín Españoles, or have your dogs more active. The Kangal dog is a lot more active